And you left Sunday Times because of political pressure. Due to you have an interesting story to relate. Due to a common or mutual friend of ours, I think you should tell the viewers what happened with that famous Suranimala.
Yes, sure. Lasantha Wickremesinghe came to me one day when I was at the Sunday Times and said, "Can I write a column for you, political column?" I knew at that time that he was the secretary to Mrs. Bandaranaike.
But didn't Rain work at Sunday
Times?
Yes,
Rain.
She was there, Lasantha's wife.
Lasantha had kept Rain there. He didn't tell me that this is the person he was going to marry. But he said, "There's a nice girl who has come back from Hong Kong. Can you give her a job?" So we hired Rain. It's only later I discovered.
I know Rain is watching this program from Melbourne.
Yes. But with regard to... Lasantha, he came and said, "Can I start this column?" I said, "Yes." But he said, "I don't want anyone to know that I am writing it," because he was Ms. Bandaranaike's secretary. I said, "Okay." So he brought it home on Saturday morning, and my wife, Lalna, typed it out, and I would take it into Sunday Times office at 3 o'clock. So no one knew what was happening. But certain things that he began to write about created certain problems.
Because he had inside stories.
He had a lot of inside stories. One was with regard to Premadasa telling Sirisena Kure, "Can you stay back after the cabinet meeting because I want to make my cabinet?" Sirisena Kure said, "I don't want to cut other people's throats," because there was this question of Gamini Dasanayake and Lalith Thattalapudi especially. He didn't want to leave them out.
So
of the
that
cabinet.
Was then Sirisena Kure said, "I don't want to cut anybody's throats." But now what's happening? So much of cut throats and throat cutting happening among the cabinet and among politicians.
Throat cutting, I mean, there's so many cabinet ministers, I don't know.
the
contrast to that time. But that led to a lot of problems, because Premadasa then began to attack me personally from stages of public stages also. Then I was told, "Can you
step down?"
No, I wasn't asked to step down, but I was asked whether I could suspend the column. That I refused, because I said journalists must have the right to say what they feel. That is why the public, by